This was more than 2 years ago, when Japan was rattled by a powerful March 11 earthquake and tsunami which claimed close to 2,000 lives across the eastern coast. Despite the passing of time, the nation remains far from recovering, as it continues to struggle not only with reconstructing the damaged regions, but also in dealing with the nuclear fallout triggered by the disaster. The Fukushima nuclear power plant, 150 miles northeast of Tokyo, was severely damaged by an earthquake and tsunami which its crucial cooling system knocked out, resulting in a series of explosions, meltdowns, and the world's worst nuclear accident in 25 years. The destruction of the Fukushima nuclear power plant in March 2011, caused by an earthquake, resulted in a massive radioactive contamination of the Japanese mainland. In November 2011, the Japanese Science Ministry reported that long-lived radioactive cesium had contaminated 11,580 square miles of land surface of Japan. Once a large amount of radioactive cesium enters an ecosystem, it quickly becomes abundant, contaminating water, soil, plants, and animals. It has been detected in a large range of Japanese foodstuffs, including spinach, tea leaves, milk, beef, and freshwater fish up to 200 miles from Fukushima. Radioactive cesium bioaccumulates, bioconcentrates, and biomagnifies as it moves up the food chain. Routine ingestion of foods contaminated with so-called low levels of radioactive cesium has been shown to lead to its bioaccumulation in the heart and endocrine tissues, as well as in the kidneys, small intestines, pancreas, spleen, and liver. This process occurs much faster in children than in adults, as children are many times more susceptible than adults to the effects of the ionizing radiation the internal organs are then exposed to. Decontamination in the exclusion zones is providing futile. Efforts to clean up highly contaminated areas are generally failing because melting snow and rainwater are not contaminated hills and return to decontaminate homes and land. Diversion ditches have failed to stop the process. Areas significantly contaminated with radioactive cesium and other long-lived radionuclides can no longer sell and export agricultural crops. Japanese scientists have found radiation from Japan's Fukushima nuclear disaster has mutated the domestic butterfly species. It may not have morphed into mortar, but the pale glass for butterfly has displayed genetic and physiological changes. The biological effects of Fukushima are just now being realized. A radioactive tuna caught in international headlines in May, and at the same time scientists from the University of Rijeka's were quietly monitoring mutations among samples of butterflies. A paper was published in the journal detailing the findings. A study was conducted by academics who declared no competing financial interests, which means there are no red flags about any sponsors involved with this research. Although epigenetic effects cannot be entirely excluded, it is most likely that the abnormal phenotypes observed are produced by random mutations caused by exposure to radiation, says one report. Mutations affected the insects' appendages, which were frequently malformed. Other abnormalities were observed in antennae, pupae, eyes, and abdomen, and wings. An uncommon wing spot pattern was also noticed in many other samples. The authors concluded that the findings were consistent with previous field studies near Chernobyl, and concluded that the butterfly was the best indicator species for the radionuclide contamination in Japan. In addition to its effects on land, the Fukushima disaster produced the largest discharge of radioactive material into the ocean in history, 15 months after 733,000 curies of radioactive cesium were pumped into the Pacific. 56% of all fish catches of Japan were found to be contaminated with it. Fishing continues to be banned off the coast of Fukushima, where 40% of bottom-dwelling fish were recently found to have radioactive cesium levels higher than the current Japanese regulatory limits. 2 years following the accident, 3 children in Fukushima area have been diagnosed with thyroid cancer, which is often a symptom of excessive radiation exposure. However, the number is too statistically small to confidently attribute to the accident, and besides, the true impact of radiation poisoning, as in Chernobyl, often only emerges years later. World Health Organization officials say that those who were infants at the time of the accident, the risk of thyroid cancer is increased by up to 70%. Although this type of tumor is still rare, the overall incidence of cancer among the most affected population is likely to be 4 to 7% higher, according to an extensive study the World Health Organization published earlier in March 2012. The Fukushima nuclear power plant, located in Japan, was severely damaged. And since the calamity, the nuclear power plant has been disabled. The lives of hundreds of thousands of people continue to be affected by the Fukushima nuclear disaster, especially the 160,000 who fled their homes because of the radioactive contamination and continue to live in limbo without fair, just and timely compensation. They have only a false hope of returning home, yet the Japanese government is eagerly pushing to restart reactors against the will of its people and without learning true lessons from Fukushima. The unfolding disaster at Fukushima nuclear power plant has been largely unreported and ignored by the mainstream media and the whole world outside of Japan. While the expertise and morale of remaining workers dwindle, as the oceans and fish around Japan are apparently aglow with radiation, and while this cause and thousands of nuclear fuel rods in and around the plant continue to present great risks to Japan and the world, Fukushima has not gone away.